half of your body is not human. Did you know that? You contain more bacterial cells than human cells. And most of those bacteria live in your gut, where they affect everything, from your mood to your weight. And when they get out of whack, they've been linked to anxiety, depression, seizures, and Parkinson's disease. So how do you keep them in check? Maintaining a healthy gut is easier than you think. I'm Dr. Ozuah, and this is The Balance.
70% of our immune system is located in the gut. Somewhere between 90 and 95% of our serotonin is from our gut. Us dietitians have been talking about gut health for many years. Part of it is that there's a lot more research, and we're finding that it's connected to so many different diseases and our mental health as well. So probiotics are the good bacteria
and are really important for our digestive system and just our overall health and wellness.
And what we call our living foods, or the fermented foods. Fermented foods that you can find are sauerkraut, pickles, kimchi, miso, tempeh, dairy products such as yogurt. And that's some of the foods that we're gonna learn about too today. New York was my introduction to a world of food. It's an amazing opportunity to live in a place where there's just every different culture you can imagine.
My patients have always wanted to understand fermented foods more.
We're gonna take a gut tour. We're gonna find out where we can locate healthy food that's good for your gut. These are just a snapshot into some of the best places that you can find these gut healthy foods. We're at Rice and Miso, and we are going to learn how to make miso soup with real miso.
I'm Mika.
Hi, Mika. Nice to meet you.
So excited to learn more about your miso.
Yeah. Come on in. My kitchen here. So this is the 3 months miso. I already boiled the water with the kelp.
Yeah. Seaweed.
Seaweed.
Which has a lot of nutritional benefits as well.
Yeah, there's a natural umami on it. It helps the gut health and digestion. And then you just cook it for a little bit.
Miso is a really easy go-to, full of probiotics. And you could find the miso paste at local grocery stores. So it's really easy to access.
I was surprised about how easy it was to make miso soup. As long as you have the miso, it takes like 3 seconds to make. Today we're gonna go and meet a gentleman named Barry Schwartz, who makes his own tempeh. Nice to meet you, I'm Jessica.
Hi, Jessica. I'm Barry, the tempeh maker.
Great.
I lived in a yoga ashram, and I was the cook there and discovered that cooking was my thing. The tempeh that you'll find in a store, like in the refrigerator section, it's pasteurized.
Right.
So it's dead tempeh. There's no live culture left to it. This culture is super robust.
Yeah.
1 gram will inoculate 10 pounds of beans because it's growing. I'm always converting people, you know, I'm always asking people to taste it, possibly because you need the gut bacteria, but it's a super satisfying food. It really tastes delicious.
Sauerkraut is a big part of Austrian living.
When you buy the sauerkraut, it's always a little bit different because it's a live product.
Sauerkraut is a probiotic. It's purely made with cabbage and salt. In an anaerobic environment, it will grow healthy cultures.
Your digestive system works better. Your metabolism works better.
Sauerkraut salad with a little bit of duck strudel.
Jessica.
Nice to meet you.
Moss Cafe, everything they make is homemade, and some of these homemade foods are some of these probiotic foods.
So we make everything. We make our own yogurt, we make our own ferments, we make all of our own sauces. We don't really buy anything pre-made. The probiotics in yogurt are so good for you. We kind of put it out there when we were first opening, like, hey, kitchen staff want to make their own yogurt. And people were sort of into the idea. We use a circulator. There's a whole process in kind of inoculating the milk, bringing it up to a certain temperature, testing its pH balance in order to, again, allow those healthy, good bacteria to grow, but not the bad ones.
Yeah.
And the milk being that so local, there's also a real probiotic health benefit to that. So it's not the simplest thing for a restaurant restaurant to take on, but in a person's own home, it would be the easiest thing to do to make your own yogurt. This like incredibly rich, delicious, perfectly sour tasting yogurt.
Our gut is our connection to the outside world. The amount of bacteria in our gut is 10 times as many cells we have in our body. That's how many we have, and we have a lot of cells. If you feel uncomfortable with your gut, then know that the diet can positively influence your health and digestion, even down the road.
It turns out that a gut feeling is more than just a feeling. I'm Dr. Ozuah. This has been The Balance. Until next time, be well.